Welcome to EVS 1. Today we're gonna see about our body. In our body there are so many things. First we're gonna see about external organs. I already told about the external organs briefly, but here we'll again recall it once. Okay, external organs. What is an organ? Our body has many parts. Those parts are known as organs, and each part has different function. So external means the parts of the body which are present outside the human body, such as the external organs are broadly divided into three, that is head, abdomen and the legs and the hands. Those are the three parts which the body is divided into. So let's see, this is the human body. If you see this human body, I told you it is the external human body, and it is divided into three, that is head, the portion is head, this is the trunk, and these two are the legs, and these two are the arms. So the human body is divided into the head, it is the trunk, and the arms and the legs. These are the three parts. So external organs are mainly three. That is, first one is you have the head, second is you have trunk, and third you have legs and arms. First we'll see about head. What is exactly head and what head contains? So the head, you know, this is the head, and the head has eyes. We have eyes, we have a nose, a mouth, and we have tongue and teeth inside. We have ears and we have hair. Okay, the head contains ears, eyes, mouth, nose and hair. These are the five things which the head contains, and the front portion of the head, these all are present here. Okay, the front portion of the head is called face. Head's front part is called as face. Someone says you have a beautiful face, that means the face is this one. So here you can see, this is the head, you have hairs, you have a pair of eyes, a nose, mouth and ears. We'll see what one of them each says about the ears. What ears are useful for? Ears, you can see, ears, here the boy is listening to the music. So ears are mainly helpful for hearing the sounds. Okay, and you see here, next you have eyes. Eyes help us to see. These are a pair of eyes and they help us to see the things. And mouth. This mouth help us to speak, like I am talking to you. This is with the help of mouth. And it is also useful to eat the food. And in the mouth, you have tongue and teeth. For example, you can see this here, you have these are the teeth and this is the tongue. Why tongue is mainly useful? The tongue is useful for taste. Like if you eat something, you know that is sweet or that is spicy or that is sour, because the tongue helps us to identify the taste. And these are the teeth. The teeth help us to cut the food into pieces, or chewing. The teeth help us for chewing. So next, nose helps us to breathe. We take oxygen inside and leave it outside. That is mainly for breathing. And also smell. You can smell the food, you can smell in the cake, you can smell curries, or you can smell anything, because nose helps us to breathe and also to smell. This last leaves the hair. What is hair? See, this is how her hair looks. See, this is how the hair looks. You can see, these are the hair strands. These are nothing but the strands on our head. The strands which are present on the head is known as hair. So that is about this. And you know, there are sense organs. The word known as sense organs. If you guys know it or not, I already told you what are sense organs. Sense organs are mainly five. They are eye, ear, nose, tongue, and skin. Okay, so I already told you eye is useful for seeing the things, ear for listening to the sounds, nose for breathing and also for smelling, tongue for tasting the food, skin, we'll see about the skin. See the skin, this is the skin, like this is all the skin, you know, this is also a skin. The skin, it is the upper layer of the body, like the body is all covered with the skin. And what is the important function of the skin? The skin, it helps us for identifying the various sensations. Like if you touch something, if you touch an ice cream, that will be cold. How you know that is cold? Because the skin senses that. And if you touch a hot water, hot boiling water, you know that is hot. Yeah, because you know, if you touch this, the board, it is hard. Yeah, if you touch a pillow, the which you sleep, it will be soft. How you know these all are soft, hard and hot, cold? Because the skin has sensations. And skin also protects us. Okay, that is about the skin. So these are the sense organs. Then this is about the head. We completed about the head. Head has ears, eyes, mouth, nose and hair. The front part of the head is called as face. And there are sense organs which are five in number. Eye, ear, nose, tongue and skin. So that completes the part of head. We are going to see what is trunk. So the trunk. Trunk is nothing but the portion below the part of the neck. So this is the neck, you know. No? Neck is the part that connects the head to the lower body. This is the neck. Okay. Now we'll see what is trunk. Trunk, it is, see, the portion below the body, below the neck, the portion, like it starts from here, this is all the neck, see, this is all the trunk, without the hands and legs. It's the body below the neck, without hands and without the legs, that is called as trunk. Okay, so trunk means, trunk starts below the neck and it is mainly without arms and legs. Arms and legs. And the trunk is again divided into two. For example, if you can see here, so this is the what you call as just a chest, because it is the hard upper and hard portion. This upper portion is very hard, so that is called as chest. And here you see the lower and smooth part is known as trunk. So this part is called as trunk and this part is known as chest. And the rear view of the trunk is called back. Like this is the back. This is portion is the chest. This portion is the abdomen and this is called back. The chest has three parts. The upper hard part called as chest, lower smooth part called as abdomen, and rear part called as back. So this is about the trunk. Trunk that is present, the region present below the neck, without the arms and legs. Trunk has three parts. The upper hard part is known as chest. The lower smooth part is known as the abdomen. And the rear part, this is called as back. That is about the trunk. The last we will see what are legs and arms. See, if you can see here, these are the legs and arms. First, we'll see about arms. we have arms on either side of the trunk. The trunk is the body, so we have arms on either side, okay, of the trunk. And the arms help us to work. See, here the carpenter, he is doing the work with the help of his hands. So hands help us to work. See the legs. Legs, these are under the trunk. These present at the side of the trunk, and legs are present under the trunk. If you can see it properly, see here, these are arms present side of the trunk, legs present below the trunk. So that's how these are. And legs, what mainly legs help us to? Help us to walk and run. You guys run in the park, you guys walk to your home with the help of these legs. Lastly, we will see what are fingers and toes. Fingers and toes, we have fingers, five fingers and five fingers to each arms, I mean each hand, and also each leg. So those five fingers are these in the hand, in this case of hand. So if you see this, the hand is like this. This is the thumb, this is the index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and the little finger. Five. This is the thumb, the index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and the last is little finger, small one. These fingers have sharp edges. These are known as nails. You see, these are called as nails. So that's about the legs and arms. We'll see legs and arms again. Legs and arms. Legs, these are present below the trunk. These are present either side of trunk, and these help us to walk and run, whereas these help us to do work. So that is about it. So legs, these are present below the trunk and they help us to walk and run. Arms present on either side of the trunk and they help us to do work. Both legs and arms have five fingers each, and each finger has a sharp edge known as the nails. That's about the full external organs. In this class, we had seen what are the external organs. In that, the external organs are divided into three parts: head, trunk, legs, and arms. In the head, we had seen what are the different parts, what are the sense organs, and in the trunk, we had seen what is our chest, abdomen and back. And legs and arms, we saw what are the legs and how legs are working, what are the arms and how arms are useful. And we also seen there are five fingers each, and they have a sharp edges called as nails. So this is about the lesson. Now we are going to do some little exercise about this. First, you see, these are the blanks. You can see here, you have blanks, you have questions, one word questions. You have some questions and you have a pictures here. We'll go one by one. So here, the parts of our body are called. I told you the body has different parts and we call them as organs. Okay. So the parts of the body are called as organs. The part which connects the head and trunk. This is the head. This is the trunk. The part which connects the head and trunk is neck. So that is neck. We feel various dash with the help of skin. I told you. We feel various sensations with the help of skin. The part of our body are called as organs. The part which connects the head and trunk is known as the neck. We feel various sensations with the help of skin. And these are one words. What do we call the front portion of the head? This is the head. I told you the front portion of the head is face. What do we call the strands on our head? This is the head. We have these strands. These are known as hair. What help us to walk and run? Walk and run. Legs. Legs help us to walk and run. Again, what do we call the front portion of our head? That is the face. What do we call the strands on our head? That is the hair. What help us to walk and run? Legs. Next, how many sense organs do we have? What are they? I told you sense organs are mainly five. They are the eyes, ears, nose, mouth, tongue, and skin. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. Those are the five sense organs. And how name the parts that are present in our head? Hair, eyes, nose, mouth, have tongue and teeth inside, and ears. What is called the trunk? Trunk is the portion below the neck without arms and without legs. That is called as trunk. How many sense organs do we have? What are they? We have five sense organs. They are the eyes, nose, tongue, ears and skin. Name the parts that are present in our head. We have hair, eyes, nose, mouth. We have tongue and teeth inside, ears. What is called the trunk? Trunk is present below the neck without the arms and without the legs. The lastly, you can see here the pictures. Okay, given a tongue here, eyes, nose and ears. They had given functions to see, to breathe, to taste, to hear. Tongue is mainly useful for tasting, so to taste. And eyes usefully for seeing, so to see. Nose is useful for smelling and also for breathing, so to breathe. Ears are useful for hearing, to hear. So this is about the exercise. This is about the today's class. In today's class, we had seen external organs. We had seen about three mainly: head, the trunk, and legs and hands. We see what different parts comes under them, and we also completed our exercise with some fill-ups, true or false, and also some more one-word questions. Thank you.